Christopher Birdie.
Coming. My name is Christopher Birdie. I did not have the pleasure of teaching this wonderful level one class. Why? What's up? My friend Bradford did. He spoke so highly of it, he sends his regrets. He wishes he could be here. But instead, it's me. Please, come on in. You have to miss the thing. So what you're about to see is the culmination of 8 weeks of this group working together. Learning the agreements and the celebrations and the disciplines of improv. We're going to see 2 shows. The material, they're going to ask for a word from you, a suggestion, and then they will give real life monologues, true stories, with which they will make art and comedy out of. I'm so glad you're here. Your job is to send love to them. They're going to be sending love to you. Nice applause, good laughs, smiles, your attention. I have got such a good vibe about this group already. Some people specifically in particular, and I think you might know who you are. But even more, I can't wait to see. So, I'm going to run upstairs and introduce the first group over the intercom. But because it's an awkward sort of run, let's just practice our applause skills and give me a real big shout, and then wait backstage until you get the microphone. But let's start that applause right now. Let me go.
All we need to get things started is a suggestion of 1 word from the top of your intelligence, please.
Space!
Space?
Space!
A little word called space is what makes me think of space is the lack of it in New York City. My first apartment in New York City was a Hell's Kitchen basement level apartment where I lived on 47th Street opposite a hotel that the word ho was missing. But it was not short in hoes, if you get my drift. There would be people banging on my window at 3 in the morning that I think and truly believe were strung out hookers who were actually thinking that they were going to the right apartment, but the place they were looking for was across the street. My apartment I shared with a very young, very inexperienced, very sweet young ballerina who was in a show with me at the time. And we had 2 bedrooms that were probably 4 by 6 maybe if we were lucky, and no windows. However, my basement apartment had a window. And unfortunately, it opened up to a family of 30, say, 40 pigeons that would fornicate in the middle of the evening. So after many, many nights of sleeplessness, I would crawl out my window in complete insanity, red eyes, bleary and insane, and try to clap them away to get them out, only to come to realize that after my inordinate amount of complaints to our horrendous landlord, who had absolutely no love for the situation we were in, had put a scrim across the air shaft and trapped all the pigeons in. But there was one pigeon who did not fly away, and that was a mother pigeon guarding her 3 eggs. Instead, she flew into my apartment and proceeded to shat all over my homemade quilt. And there is my monologue.
Probably, but I think it's kind of probably hard for her that she like can't go all the way down because the walls are so
Yeah, she hasn't got the point of ballet needs a little bit of space, you know?
So yeah.
She's doing it in tight spaces.
Show her doing here.
Just like that, actually. Yes. We're trying to find a subletter, so you're answering our ad or whatever, right?
Yeah, I am. And, oh wow, that's a lot of pigeon letter.
Yeah.
Subletter.
Yeah, so maybe we can show you around the place. This is my roommate.
Hello.
Joey. She's a boy's name, but she's a girl.
Nice to meet you, Joey.
Nice to meet you. What's your name anymore?
I'm Monica.
Monica.
Monica, that's awesome. A cool name too. It's for a girl.
Yeah. Show her the
I'm Stephanie.
Hi, Stephanie.
Now, Margaret, I don't want you to leave. You've been in my nest so long, and I just... Your warmth has warmed my backside for so long, I don't want you to leave.
It might be time. The landlord, you know, he seems pretty insistent that we go.
Yeah, he's kind of an asshole.
He's kind of an asshole.
I meant more in the sense of, like, I don't want us to part ways. I know the big great world, the big blue sky is calling out there, but I can kind of use it by my side.
So, we have a couple options. Here. We could stay in this, you know, hellscape. We could go into that nice lady's apartment over there. Or we could figure something else out.
You had me at nice lady.
So.
But you'll stay with me, right?
Yes, I'll stay with you forever and ever.
Great. Well, let's break in. I know a hole. There she is. I hope those four-limbed types like us, two-limbed, two-winged types.
Yes.
Hey!
Hey!
Your super's been kind of a dick lately.
We read that you're looking for a subletter.
Oh, and sorry, just want to come clean here. That was us that took a picture of Skits. Yeah, you looked about the windowsill, you were hungry.
Sorry, you? It's my favorite,
you know. Gonna come clean again here. We ate the hummus too.
Extend, yes, again.
in, I thought of a different kind of space. Because I am a nerd, proud nerd, and I've always loved outer space. My wife teases me that my two favorite things in the world are space and castles. That makes a nerd. But the first thing that came to my head when the suggestion of space came in was that I've always felt this connection to the constellation of Orion for some reason. And you can recognize Orion because it has these three stars in a row. There is Belt. And he's kind of sideways like this. It looks like Michael Jackson doing like a Michael Jackson thing. Ow! So next time you're looking to the night sky and you see this constellation of Orion, who incidentally was some mythic hunter or something. He like shot some famous mythical beast with a famous mythical bow. Now he gets to be in stars forever. But for some reason, whenever I was a kid, it might be because it's the only constellation besides the Big Dipper that I can recognize in the sky. That like, I'll be walking down the street, tired as hell from work, working a double, coming home from the subway, and the only thing I can see in the sky besides the moon is fucking Orion looking down on me, doing his Michael Jackson thing. And I don't know exactly what like gift he's giving me from up there, but I always know it's something. Because I like, don't feel tired from my double anymore. I don't feel as like shitty about the world as you can feel after you leave the subway. So thanks, buddy.
What did they mean to hear what they found in the newspaper? Jesus Christ.
I'm sorry, I'm stuck this way. I can't move. My hip has
okay, let me get you a chair.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ, I'm just trying to tell you about the news these days.
Just, okay, tell me about the news. What's going on in the news today?
I thought you read the paper. I don't understand you.
I slept in today.
Okay, Mom, okay. They found the Higgs boson. Oh, do you know what that means?
Shit. Is that the God shit? The God particle shit?
I don't know. That's why I called you in here.
Oh, my God.
I have no idea.
Mom, they've been trying to find that shit for a really long time.
Well, who is he?
It's a big fucking day. Who, Hick?
Yeah, this Higgs guy.
This Higgs guy. You know, they say he's God or something. I don't know. That's all I know. I told you, I don't read the paper.
I don't understand what that means for me and why everyone's so excited about this.
Well,
thank you for turning in to the 7 o'clock news. As you might have read in your paper today, the Higgs boson particle was discovered. Now we understand we all come from the same thing. We are all the same thing.
What does she mean, the same
thing? We are all the same thing?
No, I'm not the
thank
same
thing. Thank you for tuning in to the 7:03 news. You may have heard on the 7 o'clock news that we are all the same thing, but in fact, we are all the same thing and could meld together and are in fact all part of one great godly item in the entire universe.
Oh!
Therefore, there are no distinctions between us, the chair, the floor, and World War II.
Oh. No, I don't like this news. What? I want my chair. I don't give me. Get out of here. I don't want this chair.
Oh, but I kind of need this chair.
I don't know. I gotta call somebody. I'm.
Good evening. It's the 7:05 news. It's Black Friday sale on chairs at Walmart.
You're here for the pitch meeting. I'm going to be pitching my idea for this startup that I've got. Okay. So we're going to go in a few minutes. Maybe I can run it by you.
Of course.
Okay. Have you ever wanted to go to space?
Of course. Who doesn't?
Do you like castles? Okay.
Castle on the moon? Yeah.
Space castle. Okay. That's it. I feel like it just kind of explains it. But,
wait, what? That's it?
You gotta keep up with me, you know?
Okay, well,
okay. So, we'll live in this castle in space. And, okay, I need you to, like, just really go at it with me in the room with the executive.
Okay.
So, explain what I just told you, maybe.
Is there any more?
Okay. That's it? No, that's pretty much it, yeah.
Okay.
But we're going to get funding. I have a good feeling.
Hi, Donald Trump here. This is my colleague, Bill Gates.
Mr. Gates, you look different.
Melinda suggested I work out more.
It shows. Trust me. Okay, so yeah, Joey, just take it ahead.
Alright. Space castles. That's what we got.
I'm sold! Here's $10 million.
Welcome to the castle of Michael Jackson.
Oh my god.
Whoa!
Oh my god!
What's that over there?
Oh my god! What's with all the children?
In order for me to understand everyone here, I'm assuming you all know his videos. I cannot register anything that you say is valid or authentic or important unless you execute one of his famous choreographic moves.
Oh.
Do you want it together?
Okay.
Ready?
You will not be killed tonight.
Yeah!
Okay. I knew you were in that video.
Yeah, yeah, we were in the video. Yeah.
Oh, oh.
I will give you bread and water, maybe.
Do you want us to do another one? I mean,
well, let's see. What can you do? Are you able to do another one?
I believe I can
do another one. Of course,
of course we are able to do another one.
This is what we like to call the Orion belt. Yeah.
I'm starting with the man in the
undervaluing the grab the crotch move.
Grab the crotch move. Oh. So, space. It makes me think of Star Wars, which is my favorite movie as a kid, and actually, I guess, now. nothing ever really replaced Star Wars. And when I was young, I would do everything like around Star Wars, like playing Legos. Guess what? Star Wars is the thing that we're doing. I'm Luke, and this is my like fighter jet. And or we play outside. Got a stick on the ground. Guess what? It's a lightsaber, and I'm Luke. And I have like blonde hair, and so it's just a natural fit. So I would play outside with my friends a lot. Particularly one guy. His name is Bobby. He was a little bit older than me. He had bright red hair and freckles, and he was just like a ball of energy, and he was always there, and I would just dial like his phone number, like 94-3531, dial it, I don't know. And he would pick up, and that was like friendship to me. That was like, you dial the phone, they pick up, you hang out. There was no other thing about that. So we would hang out all the time, and we became best of friends, playing Star Wars, and then eventually he moved away. So he had to tell me that he was leaving. I got super sad. I was 11 years old. I was watching the World Series on TV, and I remember thinking, I don't care who wins. But I actually didn't care generally, so it was kind of like a pretty dramatic thing to make sure. I don't care if the Yankees win or whoever. So we went to his house, and we had to clean up the very last thing before they left, like, that night. It was like a movie. They were like, we gotta go, get in the car. And we were, like, plucking, like, glow-in-the-dark stars off the ceiling. I just remember this image, you know, just, like, taking these stars and just, like, walking home with them sad. Knowing I wouldn't see my friend again. So we kept in touch for a while, but I'll always remember my good friend.
Days.
How is it over there in California?
funny. My freckles are getting a little out of control, actually. I'm just like one giant freckle now. So I don't really
know. You gotta be careful about that. Remember that really bad sunburn you got on the beach last summer?
Yeah, well, we were playing with our lightsabers. It was pretty awesome. So when am I gonna get to see you? Are you gonna come visit or something?
Yeah, I was thinking about going out there.
Yeah?
Because my mom planned a trip for us.
Yeah.
So we might go to Disney World.
Can't go to Disney World? Yeah. Can't go to Disney World? Oh my gosh, that's so exciting. I wanna come. Am I gonna come?
Yeah, of course you're invited, Bobby.
Okay, cool. Let's cut to that.
Mom, Dad.
Yes.
Mom, Dad.
I'm here. I'm on the other side of the door. Dad. You heard my voice.
Why do I have to do homework? This is the worst. I hate it.
This is awkward. I'm
sorry.
Mom,
you have to at school. I mean, I don't know what to say.
Yeah, it's like hoops, son. It's like hoops. We all jump through hoops in life, and you just have to jump them. Even if they're both. Your mother doesn't want to fill out taxes. Jumps through that hoop.
But she doesn't.
Doesn't anyways.
I just wish I could play all day. I wish this pencil were like a lightsaber. I just wish I could.
We can all do that.
Be careful with that.
Yeah. I'm Boba Fett. Pew pew.
Addition. Yeah.
Sure, I can do addition.
Okay.
You guys,
teach me.
I'm doing something. I've always liked the notebook. Can we play notebook, please?
Let's get it.
You forget, lost your memories, and I'm gonna sit down and read your diary to you.
Superior to you also, so.
all love a suggestion from the top of your intelligence.
Dudley! Howie
Fox!
MTA?
I've been living in New York like 20 something years now, and when I first moved here, I lived in Washington Heights up on 185th, and I would have to take the A train, which, as some of you might know, when you get on the A train, it's express, so it goes nonstop from 59th Street to 125th, and if you've gotten on the wrong train or anything, you can't, there's nothing you can do about that, so you're stuck for about 15 minutes. Going there. So I'm on the train this one time, and it's kind of crowded, it's rush hour, and I hear this guy gets on and he goes, "What train am I on?" And people are like, "You're on the A train." And he's like, "The A train!" "Yes, you're on the A train." "Okay!" A few minutes later. "What train am I on?" "You're on the A train." The A train. Like, people are, you know, they're nice. Like, they're trying to be helpful and stuff. And, "The A train!" "Okay." So, a few minutes later, you know where this is going, I think, right? "What train am I on?" And people are, like, getting so worked up. They're like, "The A train, man. You're on the A train." We go on up to 125th with that, and he never was getting it, you know, all the way. The people were just getting more and more worked up. Anyway, I thought it was kind of amusing, but, and sweet, you know. People were trying to help and everything. So, I don't know, a few weeks go by, I don't know how long, but I'm on the A train again, and I hear the conductor go, "Stand clear of the closing doors." And, you know, there's clearly something going on blocking the doors. And you hear, "Stand clear of the closing doors." You know, like people are telling somebody and the train's crowded. And you hear, "Stand clear of the closing doors." And I thought, I know that voice.
Sleep on the train.
Not fall asleep watching the Great Gatsby.
I don't watch it, I read it. But no, I don't fall asleep. I tend to stay awake, you know, because if like random guys come on and they're like,
"Yeah, where am I?" You know, I'm like,
"They're never on the A-train."
I never have that problem.
Well, you're always sleeping.
That's true.
Yeah, I know.
It could happen while I was asleep, but I wouldn't even know it.
Yeah.
Hey! What train is this?
It's the B train, buddy!
Respond was no, it was a whopper. I hate whoppers.
How about you? Herpes? What are you gonna
Oh, hey, look. Hey. I'm Ebola. This is my train.
I want to get Ebola.
I got the A train.
You can get that pole right there.
You guys know Ebola, A train. That's us. And the 2 train, and the J train.
E. coli E train?
I don't know. We gotta have a meeting.
Look, Ebola, I'm happy to take the G train. I'm salmonella.
I mean, you can take G train.
This is not that.
What does herpes have?
I'll see you guys.
Herpes is fine. I don't care about herpes.
Alright. So, I got the J train.
I got the E train.
A train.
Okay.
What about gonorrhea? Where's gonorrhea?
Gonorrhea!
Hi.
Dude, what train do you want? You can take it.
Shuttle the Times Square.
And I remember we would just like do
do all sorts of weird shit together, and I felt like really comfortable on the train because, you know, like, it was just funny. It was like this funny environment for me. Like, I remember one time we were peeling off a sticker, and we were like sitting there laughing together, and this old lady gets up and she's like, "Ladies, start acting like ladies." She doesn't get it. One time I was on the train alone without my friend, and I was my pants always used to fall off. I like never had well-fitting pants, and I would always do this thing like I would like pull them up. And I was on the train. It wasn't too crowded. There was enough people where like you could make eye contact with like several people, but not so many people where you could like be anonymous. And and I was pulling up my pants, and I accidentally like let go of the pants, but like kept the shirt, and it just like collapsed. I was just like, and it was so like deliberate because you know I'm like.
Loves these roses, man. She wins the Church of Rose Fest every year.
Yeah. The Church of Rose Fest means so much to her.
She's gonna be so upset.
Don't she gonna be pinched?
She's not gonna be able to enter anything. Fuck yeah!
I'm gay and you're just talking in that MTA thing. You notice I'm like trying to connect here.
When a subject like this comes up, I'm a police officer and I'm gay.
We'll see you at the bar.